In this video, we're going to compute the electric field due to an electric dipole at an observation point that lies along the axis of the dipole. This is sometimes called an axial point. So for the setup of the problem, we have an electric dipole in our picture, and that's a pair of charges with magnitude Q. One of them's positive, one is negative, and these opposite charges have a separation distance of D. We're going to define our observation point at a distance of r relative to the right-hand positive charge here. And we see the electric field points to the right out there, and that's because we're closer to the positive q that gives us a rightward contribution to the field than we are to the negative q, which gives us a leftward contribution to the field. So our first goal is to write down the electric field at this observation point. But then, as we see in the statement of the problem, the interesting part is that we want to take the large distance limit of our answer and use a binomial approximation to explore the R dependence of the field magnitude. Finally, we want to express our final answer in terms of the dipole moment, which is defined to be P equals Q times D. So to get started, we just use the formula for the electric field of a point charge, and we add together the contributions from each of our charges. So the contribution from our positive charge is going to be Q over 4 pi epsilon 0 R squared, and we're giving that a plus sign because it points to the right here. The contribution from the negative charge is going to point to the left, so we'll put a minus sign out in front. And we have a Q over 4 pi epsilon 0, but this time the distance to the observation point is R plus D, so we're going to square that in the denominator. So we can factor the Q over 4 pi epsilon 0 out of this. And this leaves us with a Q over 4 pi epsilon 0 multiplied by this quantity 1 over R squared minus 1 over R plus D quantity squared. So that's actually one way to write the total electric field at this observation point, but of course we want to do some more work with it. One thing I'm going to do before I get into the binomial approximation is I want to factor an r squared out of the denominators in those parentheses. And what's left in the parentheses then is a 1 minus, and then dividing an r squared out of the denominator in our second term here, we end up with a 1 plus d over r quantity squared. So there's our total electric field at the observation point, and we've isolated this term out in front that looks very much like the field of a point charge, and then it's multiplied by this term in parentheses that's modifying it. And that's the part we want to try to understand better in the large R approximation. So when I say the large R approximation, I mean when the distance from this dipole is much greater than the separation between the two charges, so when R is much greater than D. In that limit, D over R must be a very small thing. And here's where we recognize the opportunity to use a binomial approximation. Whenever we have 1 plus a small thing raised to a power, we can use a Taylor polynomial to approximate this thing. So just as a quick reminder, if x is small and I have 1 plus x to the n, that's going to be approximately equal to 1 plus nx. And this comes from truncating a Taylor series. The next term would be quadratic. It would have an x squared in it, but if x is very small, that's negligible. So that's why we're able to truncate this. So if I apply this to the binomial in our problem, I'm going to rewrite it as a 1 plus d over r to the negative 2 power, where again, d over r is a very small thing. So we use the binomial approximation and rewrite that as a 1 plus nx. In other words, 1 minus 2, that's the original exponent, times my small thing, that was d over r. Our ones are going to cancel here, and we distribute this minus sign into the parentheses, and we get a positive result. And I'm left with 2qd over 4 pi epsilon 0 r cubed, which we can clean up just a little more by canceling a factor of 2, and then replacing qd with the dipole moment p. So because we went through the process of using this binomial approximation in the large r limit, we now have a clear sense for how the electric field is dropping off as we move far away from the dipole compared to the separation distance of the charges. So E is actually dropping off as a 1 over r cubed instead of a 1 over r squared. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.